If you like my content, please like and click on the subscribe button. Click on the drop-down and select all to see regular updates.
Greetings everyone. Welcome back to my channel, Data Sculptor. Today, we are going to see another interesting SQL question. So, we have a table called orders where we have two columns, customer name and order date. If you observe carefully, all these three customers, there are three customers, Alice, Bob and Charlie. And each of the customer has some order date. So the output is you need to return the customers who have placed orders in consecutive weeks, in three consecutive weeks. So if you see, Alice and Charlie are the outputs because they have placed the orders in three consecutive weeks. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see what is the logic behind it and how to return this using SQL. If you are watching our videos for the first time, make sure you click on the subscribe button and also click on the like button. So before we deep dive into writing the query, I'd like to explain how we can solve this. So first, for each and every order date, retrieve the work week. So there is a function called date part in SQL. I'm talking about MS SQL. So using that date part function, you can retrieve all the weeks. So here Alice has placed an order on April 1st, which is work week 14. And on April 9th, 15, April 17, 16, April 18 is also 16, and April 24 is 17. So 14, 15, 16, and 17. So Alice has placed orders in four consecutive weeks. So Alice's name is written because our question is we need to return the customers who have placed orders in three consecutive weeks. Okay. So if you see Bob has placed an order on April 11th, which is work week 15, and May 2nd and 9th, which is 18 and 19. So Bob has placed order only in two consecutive weeks. So Bob will not be returned. And Charlie, here this is the tricky part. So for Charlie, if you see, order is placed on December 23, which is work week 52. And December 29, which is work week 53. And on January 5th, which is work week 2. So here, if you see, the work week is 53 and 2. So even though these are consecutive weeks, these two, that work week is not consecutive. That means here it is, the work week is not incremented by one. So this is the challenge where orders are placed in cross years. Okay. So this is the way you find. So first you'll find all the work weeks for each and every transaction. And then you see what are the consecutive work weeks here. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see how to solve this. So this is the input as we discussed. So if you want to practice this and if you want to practice it on your own, you can copy this DML and DDL script from the description of this video. So now we have this input. So first, as discussed, I will be calculating the work week of each and every order data. So select star comma date part of WW comma order date. So as work week from orders order by 1, 2. So what is happening here, date part function, I'm writing it WW because I want the work week of the order date. Okay. So if I mention WW, it will give me, return me the work week. So if you run this query, you're getting the work weeks 14, 15, 16 and 17 and whatever it is. Okay. If you write YY, you will get it in years. What is the year? So you'll get 24, 25 and all, but we want the work week only. So I'll just simply write work week. Okay. WW. So now we are getting the work week here. Okay. Now what I will do with this, I will create a previous work week. So here what I'll create, I'll create a new column and where I will calculate the work week difference between two consecutive orders. So how do I do this? So there is a function called DATEDIFF. Okay, so DATEDIFF, what will it do? It will calculate the work week difference. Okay, so DATEDIFF of WW comma, so first date is order date, order underscore date comma previous order. So lag of previous order is order date. So order date, again I want the previous order, over partition by order underscore date, sorry, partition by customer name, customer underscore name order by order date. Okay, order by order date as work with diff. Okay, so now this is the function. I have to close this. So now if I run this, you will get the work week difference between all the work weeks. So here the first work week you will get null. Okay, because null here we are getting null because before the this is the first order, so there is no previous order for this first order, so it will always be null. Okay, so now I will keep this in a CTE with CTE as. Okay, so if I keep this in a CTE, select star from CTE. So I'll just try to understand what is the columns here. So column names are customer name, order date, work week and work week difference. Okay, so I have to ignore some rows here. So if you see these two rows, I will ignore one of the row because these two are the same work week. So I don't want multiple rows here. I can delete one of the rows. So I'll ignore the rows where work week difference is zero. The reason why I'm ignoring the rows is because I will be calculating the current work week difference minus previous work week difference. I'll explain you more earlier and more in the next steps. But for now, I'm filtering out work week difference is equal to zero. So where work week difference is not equal to zero. So wherever work week difference is zero, I'm removing those rows. Okay. So I want the first row is null as well. So is null. So comma minus one. So I don't want to ignore the null. Wherever work week difference is null, I don't want to ignore the rows. I just want to ignore the rows where work week difference is zero. So that's why I'm writing is null. If I do not write is null condition, this row also will go away. But I want these rows. So now I have removed this row and got the required rows. Okay. So now what I will do here is I will create one more column using the lag function. So here if you see for work week difference for the first row, it is null. For the second row, it is minus one. So whatever work week difference is, I will get the previous row work week difference as well. Okay. So for this previous row work week difference is null. Okay. So what I will do here, lag of work week difference over partition by customer underscore name, order by order underscore date as previous work week diff. Okay. So now if I run this, let's see what we are getting. So if you see here, previous work week difference I am getting. So for the Alice row, there is no previous work week difference because current work week difference is also null and previous work week difference is also null. And for the second row, current work week difference is minus one and previous work week difference is null. Okay. And for the third row, it is minus one and minus one, and fourth row again it is minus one and minus one. Okay. So here, and if you observe for Bob again, so for first row, it is both the values are null, which is fair enough. And for the second row, work week difference is minus three and previous work week difference is null. And again for Bob, third row, work week difference is minus one and previous work week difference is minus three. And for Charlie again, so even though it is cross here, the work week difference you are getting still minus one because date diff function will automatically consider if you write date diff of work week, even though it is crossed over the year, even though there is a cross year dates, it will automatically consider. So you need not worry about that. So here minus one you are getting, and previous work week difference also you are getting minus one. So now if you see here, the logic to write is from this entire data, I will filter out only the rows where work week difference plus previous work week difference is equal to minus two. Okay. So if you see here, minus one and minus one you are getting. So minus one, that means if current work week difference is minus one, that means the previous record is the difference for the previous record is one. And previous work week difference is also minus one. That means the previous two work weeks. So for the current work week, if you observe for this work week 16 row, work week difference is minus one. So 16 and 15 is minus one. And previous work week difference, that means 15 and 14. So this previous work week difference is nothing but difference 15 and 14. So if this both are minus one, that means this particular transaction is coming under three consecutive work weeks. Okay. So that's why I'll filter out minus one and minus one. I'll filter out minus one and minus one. Okay, and similarly, if you see for Bob, 18, your for transaction 18, work week 18, the work week difference is minus 3. And for work week 19, work week difference is minus 1. So here it is minus 3. So that means this particular row is not coming under 3 consecutive work weeks. Say if you are having one more row where work week is 20, then you will get minus 1 and minus 1 again. But here that is not the data. So you will get minus 1 and minus 3. And for Charlie, again if you see for this particular row, this particular work week 2 and work week 53 difference is minus 1, okay, which is fair enough. That means these are consecutive rows. And previous work week difference, that is work week difference between work week 53 and 52, that is also minus 1. So if these two are minus 1, that means all these three records and three consecutive work weeks. So now what I'll do, I'll just keep this in a CTE 2, okay, as this, and select from CTE 2, where work week difference is equal to minus 1 and previous work week difference is equal to minus 1. So if both these are minus 1, I will return only the distinct customer names. Okay, so once I run this query, you will get Alice and Charlie. So in this way, we will get all the customers who are placed orders in 3 consecutive work weeks. So hope you all understood the question and also the solution. So if you like this, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. And also if you are having a better solution, make sure you post it in the comment section so that I'll also learn, and also other viewers who are looking for more optimized solutions can also view that. So thank you. Have a nice day.